I have heard way too many Joel Embiid needs to stay off social media takes. I've had enough. I think he needs to stay on social media forever. In fact, I would tweet every day if I were Joel Embiid. In fact, I would have tweeted at Marcus Morris last night after he tried to start at Donnybrook and then got swatted like a fly. Joel Embiid needs to stop posting on social media? You know what I saw last night? You know what I saw? I saw him smile for the first time maybe all season long. There have been restrictions, obviously. Not just minutes restrictions, but social media restrictions. Ever since he lashed out at Karl Anthony Towns, he's laid low. He's laid back. And we haven't seen that fire. We haven't seen that smile. We haven't seen Joel Embiid be Joel Embiid until last night. Until he fooled an entire city. Well, like 69% of it. Because the city of Philadelphia is so gullible and stupid. I cannot believe how many people fell for that. You don't know, you don't understand Joel Embiid's personality by now. He's a troll. He's a prankster. He's a jokester. He was having fun. Having fun is something he really hasn't been doing much this year. But guess what? I think the handcuffs are off. And I think Joel Embiid's going to be allowed to do whatever Joel Embiid wants. And no. That doesn't mean he should stay off social media. Some people are just wired a little bit differently than others. In fact, I can make the argument that social media actually helps Joel Embiid. It can help him get going. In fact, I suggested that the Sixers team as a whole needs to start talking some more shit on the floor as a way to get themselves up for some opponents. Joel Embiid needs to have fun. He needs to be a troll. He needs to be himself. And look at what we saw last night. We saw dominance. We saw dominance from the entire team. We saw a shift in mindset, at least for one game. It's one game, and it's not a road game, but I saw signs. Now, I spoke to the team about a month ago, true story. I talked to them about three-point shooting. So 41 games into the year. Now, we've played about 12 to 13 games since I've done this study, but I had come to the conclusion that the Sixers were taking way, way, way too many three-pointers. Obviously, Brett Brown, he's got his system, right? Well, unfortunately, the Sixers, they didn't really have the pieces and the personnel that fit the system. So this team kept chucking and hoisting threes despite the fact that they weren't going in. So here were my findings about a month ago. I'll have to re-update this, but here we go. All right. So here's basically the kibbles and the bits. When the Sixers shoot under 30 three-pointers, they win. When they play bully ball, like they did last night, when they dominate the paint, when they attack the rim relentlessly and at will, they dominate. The Clippers played really, really well last night. Kawhi Leonard could have easily went for 40 if Ben Simmons wasn't on. Sixers dominated the paint. And I've been waiting for that all season long. We saw like the first couple games of the year, if you remember, Boston and again that game against Minnesota, Karl Anthony Towns, Joel Embiid, they have the little fiasco. Ever since then, not a lot of bully ball. Last night we had bully ball. Another move that they made. If you watched my video on Saturday, I told you the Sixers, they were watching because they put Al Horford on the bench. I told you. Al Horford was put on the bench. That allows for more room for Joel Embiid to operate. Now, The other one who deserves some credit in this whole thing is Elton Brand. Because Elton Brand is the one who made a trade happen when a lot of people might have thought that they really couldn't execute much of anything due to the lack of resources. Well, he sent 3 second-round picks to Golden State for Clifford Robinson III and Alec Burks. And those guys help the bench and offer more roster flexibility to make it an easier decision to put Horford on the bench. You can just start somebody. You can start Toby at the 4 and whoever you want at the 3, whether it's Robinson, Burks, Korkmaz, or Matisse Thybulle, whoever that might be. But Al Horford last night, ooh, I just like burped while I talked. That was weird. Al Horford last night had a really good game. Arguably one of his better games of the season. The way he defended, protecting the paint, he was outstanding. And then even offensively. Let's see, what did he do offensively? Seemed like he did better. Let's see. He had 9 points on 3 of 4 shooting. So, but from what I saw, he looked more comfortable out there. He played 28 minutes. He played the same amount of minutes as Joel Embiid. So he's still getting the minutes. He's still, you know, he's not going to be above 30, I guess. But he's going to be in the high 20s. And he's going to be a very important facet off the bench. And, you know, I hope this is something that Al is okay with, because this is going to help the team. This helps Joel Embiid. This helps Al Horford. This helps the bench. This helps the entire team. I was very encouraged by what I saw last night. By the way, I forgot to mention in my study for the 3-point shots. So in 25 wins, and by the way, this was done a month ago again, to reiterate, 41 games into the season. So in the 25 wins, they were averaging just 29.64 3-point attempts a game. In the losses, they're one attempt higher. In 16 losses, 30.88. Now, if you take away 3 of their higher attempt shooting, because they had 41 3-point attempts against the Bucks, and they also had 38 and 36. So you take those 3 away, it was 28.45. So basically, the gist is this. When they're under 30 and they're attacking the rim and they're attacking the paint, they're going to win basketball games, and that's what they did last night. Now, can they do this on the road? Can they take this on the road? Because this, of course, is where their downfall has been. They're 9-18 on the road, 1-12 against teams with over 500 records. So this is a mindset that's going to have to translate, obviously, away from Wells Fargo Center. But what I saw last night is exactly what I want to see the second half of the season. Ben Simmons as well. Let's just get to him and talk about him for a second. I mean, he's been outstanding the final month, last month of the year. Maybe I'll talk about him in another video, but because not to like share too much, but outstanding defense yesterday. But it's what he was doing in the half court. You know, some guys don't really think he has an offensive game in the half court, and he was showing that he could score. He took 22 shots last night. Took 22 shots. Ben Simmons got drunk last night. 22 shot attempts that led the team. When's the last time he led the team in shot attempts? I'll have to look that up. 43 minutes, 12 of 22, had a second straight triple-double, 12 rebounds, 10 assists. I mean, Ben Simmons is turning a corner here, and I hope you guys see it, and I hope you guys appreciate it, because most of you want to see the jumper so bad, you overlook the other parts of this game. It's funny to me how somebody can look at the fact that, like, he doesn't have a jump shot, and they just talk down about him so badly. But if somebody can't play defense, that doesn't get the same effort and the same energy. I don't see that at all. So it's like the guys who can't shoot, you get on them, but you can't get on the guys who can't defend. You know, it's one facet in the game that he will improve on. It's just not there right now. So, Sixers, an encouraging win last night. Joel Embiid needs to keep having fun. He needs to keep staying on Twitter. All right. I am not taking the take that, no, I'm not going to be saying that he needs to stay off social media. You need to understand his personality. You need to understand who he is. He smiled for the first time all season last night. He seemed like he had a good time on the floor for one of the very few times this season. If he's allowed to have fun, be on social media, be his kidding self again, I love it. And shame on you, Philadelphia, for being so stupid. Oh, my God. You really fell for this? You really fell for this? Joel Embiid and Jimmy Butler tag teaming? You believe this shit? You think he's going to go to Miami? The Process? He's nicknamed the fucking Process. All right? He's not going to change his nickname. He's not going to Miami. It's not happening. He's staying in Philadelphia. He's staying in Philadelphia forever. And that's it. Relax. Oh, so gullible, you Philadelphia.